Taking Control with Dr. Josh.
Didn't you know that up to 75% of adults have sleep problems at least a few nights a week? Each year, there are up to 100,000 traffic accidents involving drowsiness. This week is National Sleep Awareness Week, and joining us to talk about how we can improve the quality of our sleep is UAB psychologist Dr. Josh Klapo. Thanks for joining us,
sure,
as
Stephen.
Always.
Sure.
This is a topic that people hear about and maybe experience, but this is a real important situation people need to focus on.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the research just keeps coming out more and more showing that problems with sleep and sleep deprivation are not just associated with accidents, like you said, but problems with obesity, heart disease, mental health problems. And here's the thing, most sleep problems can be fixed with our actions, not any other way. I mean, they really can be fixed with actions that we take, and that's really important.
Well, that is good news, so let's get right to it. What can people do?
Well, there's a laundry list, but let's sort of hit the highlights. Number one, consistency in bedtime and wake up time. So basically trying to go to bed the same time every night and get up the same time every night, even on weekends. And that can be hard, but the more consistent, the better your sleep.
And you also mentioned bed only for sleeping, having some specific uses for that bed.
Yeah, and that really is talking about things like you don't want to be doing work or paying bills or even trying to watch TV, things like that. You want your bed associated with sleep so that your body recognizes the bed to be associated with sleep.
And I know you have a few more tips as well.
Absolutely. You want to avoid alcohol, caffeine, and nicotine about 2 hours or more before bedtime. Interferes with your sleep. You want to avoid exercise 2 hours or less to bedtime. Exercise is great, but if you exercise too close to bedtime, your metabolism is basically too jacked up. Most important one, though, that people don't do, have a sleep routine. Most people go, 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 go. They put their head down on the pillow and their eyes are wide open and they're wondering why they're not sleeping. About a half hour before bedtime, you want to start winding down. Reading a book, listening to music, writing in a journal, basically telling your body, hey, guess what? We're about to go to sleep. The most interesting thing is if you do these things, it will fix the vast majority of sleep problems. If you still have problems, you definitely want to talk to your physician.
You also mentioned avoid naps. Now, that's something that people want to take sometimes, but what are the negatives of taking naps?
One of the problems with naps, unless it's for folks like you or others who are on sort of strange sleep cycles where they need to get in that extra sleep, the problem with naps is that it can interfere with a normal nap, with a normal sleep cycle. If you have a regular nap time and you're still able to go to sleep at night and you're still able to sleep, it's fine. But what you don't want to do is try to keep catching up by taking naps and then having that interfere with your nighttime sleep.
Very good. So it's good to know there are tips. They may sound easy at face value, but you got to take these actions. But we can hopefully succeed in finding a better, more routine situation to sleep.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you so much.
Sure.
Back to you.